Good evening students. In our previous video we have discussed about the structure of tooth in detail, that is the various parts and the layers of the tooth. So in this segment we will be discussing about the lingua, and we are discussing about the mouth parts only. We are not completed yet. One more topic of salivary glands is left in the mouth parts. So let me discuss about the lingua. Lingua means nothing, it is tongue only. So tongue is medically it is called as lingua. Tongue is medically called as lingua. So again, it is a kind of musculosensory organ. Musculosensory organ, that means it is made up of muscles. Sensory means it has the capacity. First of all, let us write. It is a musculosensory organ. Musculosensory organ means what? Muscular, that means it is made up of muscles, mainly skeletal muscles. Sensory means it has the capacity of sensation. It has the capacity of sensation, that means it has the capacity to detect the taste. So tongue has the capacity to detect taste. How it will detect the taste? There are various numerous receptors which are located, that you will see in the later on part, but it is a musculosensory organ. Location of the tongue. If you remember our previous session when we have discussed about the palates, what statement we have used for the palate location is that palates are located on the roof of the buccal cavity. So floor of the buccal cavity is occupied by lingua, that is tongue. So location wise it is located on the floor of buccal cavity. It is located on the floor of the buccal cavity. It is not a free structure, it is attached to some hanging structure. So it is located at the floor of the buccal cavity via frenulum. It is located on the floor of the buccal cavity via frenulum. Now what is this frenulum? When you lift up your tongue in the buccal or the oral cavity, you will find some V-shaped edge-like structures in the anterior part or near the lower jawbone. That structure is very soft, a kind of skinny structure. That is what we call it as frenulum. So it is located on the floor of the buccal cavity, attached via the frenulum, that is attachment to the buccal cavity. It is a musculosensory organ. Now it is free on the anterior side, but posterior it is not free. So it is free anteriorly but not posteriorly, or let us write it as it is free on the anterior sides only. That means if suppose this is the posterior most end of the lingua, that is the tongue, then this would be the anterior part. This would be the anterior part and this is the posterior most part of the tongue. So it is free anteriorly, location wise on the floor of the buccal cavity, attached via frenulum. It is a musculosensory organ. Now tongue, we just now spoken about that it has the capacity to detect taste. That's why we are using the word sensory organ, that means it has the capacity to sense something. And what is this something? Nothing but the taste. Sensation of taste is performed by the tongues. So what is the speciality that what tongue has through which it can detect the taste? So tongue has the numerous projections which are called as papillae. So tongue has numerous projections. These projections are called as papillae. These projections are called as papillae, P-A-P-I-L-L-A-E, papillae. And these papillae bear taste buds. And these papillae bear taste buds. And the taste bud is the actual structure that will detect taste. Clear? So tongue has numerous projections which are very irregular in shape. These projections are called as papillae. Some are circular, some are like inverted V shape, like that. Some are conical in shape. So these projections, which are irregular projections in the tongue, are called as papillae. And these papillae bear the taste buds. The taste bud has the capacity to detect taste. So now let us discuss about the papillae. So So mainly three types of papillae are there. That is the valid papillae, fungiform papillae, as well as filiform papillae. And this is very important for competitive exams. So let us discuss about the papillae in turn. So papillae in turn, or the limba part. The first is valid papillae, the fungiform papillae, as well as filiform papillae. So valid papillae. Second is fungiform papillae. Valid papillae, fungiform papillae, and the third one is filiform papillae. Okay, filiform papillae. So one by one we will discuss. Let us discuss first about the valid papillae. So valid papillae, they are located in a kind of circumference. So that's why it is also called as circumference valid or circumvalid papillae. It is more appropriately it is called as circumvalid papillae. And it is mainly located in the posterior most part of the tongue. Location wise, it is located in the posterior part of the tongue or posterior part of the limba. So if we have to draw the diagram or you have to label the valid papillae, it is present somewhere there. In these regions, the valid papillae are located. So let us label these valid papillae also. These are valid papillae. Clear? It is also called as circumvalid papillae. Why it is called as a circumvalid papillae? Because the structure or the location wise it is present in the circumference region of the tongue. That's why they are using the word circumvalid papillae. Location wise, on the posterior most part of the tongue or the lingua, this is the anterior most part. Now, the number of valid papillae are very few. So few in number, approximately 8 to 12. In many reference book you may see the 8 to 10 valid papillae. So nearby around 8 to 10 or 8 to 12 valid papillae are located in the posterior most part of the human tongue. Number it is very few, but the size is larger. The size is larger, as we have just now spoken that it is present in the form of circumference. So that's why we are also using the term circumvalid papillae. So for valid papillae, the location it is located on the posterior most part of the lingua, that is tongue. Number very few, 8 to 12 or 8 to 10. Size is very large, but the number is few. And let us discuss about the second most important or the shape. Second most important feature of the valid papillae is it is inverted V-shaped. Papillae are called as valid papillae. So shape wise it is inverted V shape, size is larger, number are very few, approximately 8 to 10 or 8 to 12 valid papillae are located on the posterior most part of the human tongue. Circumvalid papillae is another name of valid papillae. Now let us discuss about the second papillae, that is fungiform papillae. I am writing it here only, fungiform papillae. So fungiform papillae, few in number, 8 to 12 for valid papillae, but here the number is numerous, so it is greater in number as compared to the valid papillae. So number wise, number is more as compared to the valid papillae. Okay, and where they are located? They are located on the margins. If you see, the valid papillae are located in the posterior most region, but the fungiform papillae are located, so location wise it is located where? In the margins, all around the margins of the tongue the fungiform papillae are located, on the margins the fungiform papillae are located. Shape is like mushroom shape. If you know from your previous study, the mushroom is a kind of fungal species, so that's why fungiform, that means the shape is like a fungus and the fungus is the mushroom. Okay, so number is more as compared to valid papillae, location they are located on the margins. Now shape, shape is like mushroom. So if we have to draw the mushroom shaped papillae, it would be something like this. Clear? So shape is like a mushroom. So let us label the fungiform papillae in the diagram of tongue. This is the structure of tongue. Human tongue would be more appropriate. So these fungiform papillae are located in all around the margins. So here in the margins, these fungiform papillae are located. Let us label these fungiform papillae in the margins all around the tongue. So this is fungiform papillae. Okay, so location wise on the margins, shape is like a mushroom and the number is more as compared to valid papillae. The third most or the papillae is filiform papillae. Filiform papillae. Filiform papillae number is again more as compared to the valid as well as fungiform papillae. Again, what we will write? Number. They are numerous. That means they are present in very large quantity. Location wise, it is present in the centermost region of the tongue. So location is centermost region. At the central region of the tongue, the filiform papillae are located. If we have to discuss about the shape, shape is like, let us discuss about or label first the filiform papillae. So filiform papillae, mainly they are located in the central most region. So all around this region, the filiform papillae are located. Clear? The dotted shape structure is what we call it as the filiform papillae. So filiform papillae. Shape, to be more appropriate, it is shown as a dot, but actually it is a kind of conical shape. Clear? And the most important thing that you have to remember regarding the filiform papillae is that filiform papillae does not bear any taste bud at all. That means this papillae will not be involved in the perception of detection of the taste. So filiform papillae has no taste buds. Has no taste buds. So this is all about the three papillae, that is the valid papillae, which is located in the circumference region in the most posteriormost part of the lingua, fungiform papillae in the margins, filiform papillae located in the centralmost region. Shape is conical and it is like mushroom. Valid papillae shape is like the inverted V-shaped structure. Now let us discuss about the functions of tongue and how it detects the taste. That means which type of taste is detected by the tongue and which portion of the tongue detect that particular taste. So functions of the tongue. The first most important function is capacity or ability to detect taste. So first function, functions of tongue. First, it acts as a gustatoreceptor. Again, I'm repeating, it acts as a gustatoreceptor. So the first function is it acts as a gustatoreceptor. Gustatoreceptor. Now, what is the meaning of this term gustatoreceptor? Gustatoreceptor is nothing, that means the receptors which have the capacity to detect taste. So it acts as a gustatoreceptor. So these are the receptors that detect taste. Okay, so first most important function of the tongue is it acts as a gustatoreceptor. Mainly the tastes which are detected are sour, salty, bitter taste as well as sweet taste. Now let us this A, B, C and D. That is sour, salty, bitter and sweet taste are detected by the tongue. Now let us see which portion of the tongue detect these four tastes. Sour and salty taste is mainly detected by the lateral parts of the tongue. That means these regions are the one which has the capacity to detect sour and salty taste. So So let us label the, let us say this is actin or acting as a gustatory receptor for the SOR, and this is for salty taste. Tip, that means located in the anterior most part of the tongue, it will detect the sweet taste. So this region will detect the sweet taste, and this region, that is uppermost region of the posterior most region, will detect the bitter taste. So let us write a few statements about these four tastes. Sour and salty, mainly it is detected by the lateral parts, that is the side most part. It is detected by lateral regions. Bitter taste is detected by the posterior most region, detected at the posterior end, and the sweet taste is detected at the tip. It is detected at, or it is detected by the tip region. The second most important function of the tongue is it helps in the articulation of speech. So you might have experience also that when we are speaking, we utilizes our tongue to speak, or the words which come out from the buccal cavity of the mouth is because of the tongue only. So the second most important function is it helps in articulation of speech. It helps in the articulation of speech. Third important function of the tongue is it acts as a natural toothbrush. It acts as a natural toothbrush. So you have observed an experience in your day-to-day life that we keep on rolling the tongue in our buccal cavity. When we roll tongue, it touches our teeth. So all the debris and all the waste will be discarded out. So the third most important function is it acts as a natural toothbrush. Thereby, it clears all the debris and the waste from the buccal or the oral cavity. The fourth important function of the tongue is it helps in swallowing. It helps in swallowing. So what is the advantage when you swallow the food? The food will be easily passed on to the tubular part, that is the esophageal part of the buccal cavity, and thereafter it goes to stomach and the digestion of the food will begin. The fifth most important function of the tongue is it helps the mixing of food with the saliva. Okay, because we use our tongue only to roll the food in the buccal cavity or the oral cavity, so it helps the food to mix with saliva. Now what is the advantage of mixing the food with saliva? That part we will discuss later on when we will discuss about the salivary glands in detail. So this is all about the tongue region, the important functions, and the location wise papillaries, taste buds and all. In the next segment we will discuss about the last important topic of mouth parts, that is the salivary glands.